The moment we look at a website, I'm sure many of us would feel that they want to create one just like that or make some improvements in the one they are seeing. So when it comes to creating websites, I'm sure Angular is definitely the best framework to help you master website creation. So hey guys, welcome back to a whole new session from Edureka. My name is Vajiha, and this session brings to you all that you need to know about Angular in 2020. So we shall first begin with the drawbacks of AngularJS and the rise of Angular. Then we shall take a look at what is Angular, who uses Angular, and why is it so popular. Following that, we'll be taking a look at the new features of Angular 8, Angular developer salaries, and the skills that Angular developers need to possess. So before we begin, just make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with all the latest Edureka videos. Also, if you're interested in getting an online training certification in Angular, check out the link given in the description box below. A web developer, as we all know, is someone who creates web applications. These web applications can either be traditional web applications or single-page applications. In traditional web applications, the page reloads for each and every request that is passed by the user, making it way too slow. Single-page applications, on the other hand, resolve this frequent reloading issue of web pages for each and every request. Single-page applications have a heavier usage of AJAX, a way to communicate with backend servers without doing a full-page refresh to get data reloaded into our application. As a result, the process of rendering pages happens mostly on the client side. A good example of a single page application is your Gmail account. Okay, so there are many frameworks that will help you create single page applications, but the best one is definitely Angular. Before talking about Angular, let's take a look at AngularJS and the rise of Angular. AngularJS is an open source front-end JavaScript framework for creating single page web applications. It was developed by Google in 2002. There is no doubt that AngularJS was very popular in its time, but AngularJS lacked many important features that were being offered by other JavaScript frameworks in the market. AngularJS had large bundle size, performance issues, and did not support mobile devices. Therefore, to resolve these issues, Angular was created. Since then, Angular has taken over AngularJS, but the Angular community has said that they will extend the support for AngularJS applications until the 30th of June 2021. Now let's move on and discuss about Angular in detail. Angular is an open source web application that is maintained by Google. It is based on TypeScript, which is also an open source programming language developed by Microsoft. TypeScript is basically the superset of JavaScript. With TypeScript, Angular introduced an object-oriented programming paradigm into web development. The TypeScript programming language is designed for the development of large applications. It needs to be transcompiled to JavaScript as the browser only supports JavaScript language. AngularJS and Angular are completely different frameworks, guys, and therefore, in order to learn Angular, no knowledge of AngularJS is required. So who do you think uses Angular and why is it so popular? Angular is widely used by many companies to create their websites. Some of them are Google, Microsoft, Samsung, VMware, Santander, etc. Talking about Angular's popularity, there are many reasons why Angular is very popular. The first being Angular is easy to use. Angular allows its users to create full-fledged professional websites with much lesser code when compared to its rivals, the MVC architecture. The Angular framework is based on MVC or the Model View Controller architecture, where models serve as the base and contain all the data. The views, on the other hand, deal with what the user sees. Compatibility. Angular works on client-side, which makes it compatible for both desktops and mobile applications. Provides filters. Angular provides filters to filter out data of different types, such as numbers, lowercase and uppercase letters, etc. Not just that, you can also design your own filters according to your requirements. Two-way data binding. Angular allows two-way data binding, which means if any changes are made to the models, the corresponding views also get updated accordingly. Modularity. Modularity is definitely one of the biggest reasons for Angular popularity. Developers can make use of different modules to create single-page applications with ease. Testing abilities. Angular provides easy and simple testing as a result of its module separation feature. Flexible and extensible. Angular is very accommodating when it comes to integrating with the existing technology stack. As a JavaScript client-side tool, it can be used with any server-side technology that is in use today. It also gets along well with the client-side technologies and can be customized in such a way that it is not interfering with the existing setups. Okay, so now moving on towards Angular 8. Angular 8 requires TypeScript 3.4 for web development. Opt-in IV preview. Ivy is the name given to Angular's next generation compilation and rendering pipeline. This will help you optionally preview your website to see how it works. Differential loading. As a part of its build process, Angular 8 CLI will be able to produce both legacy and modern JavaScript bundles. This implies a differentially loaded client side with improved speed and time to interactive for the present browsers. Backward compatibility of routers will help in simplifying the upgrade path for large projects. Opt-in usage sharing. With this feature, the Angular team will be able to collect anonymous information with your consent to keep the track of commands that are used and the time taken to build your projects. Dependency updates. Angular 8 has updated the dependencies on tools like RxJS, Node, and TypeScript. This was done for better performance and sync with the current environment. Web worker bundling. Web workers allow you to write code that runs separately from the main thread. This improves speed by parallelizing multiple tasks. The developers of Angular 8 have added bundling support for web workers as a result of requests from various developers. Okay, so now let's move on and take a look at the Angular developer salaries. Angular developers are one of the most in-demand professionals in the industry. The average salary for an Angular developer depends on whether he is just a web developer or a full-stack developer. According to Indeed, an entry-level web developer earns about $105,000 per year, whereas a full-stack developer makes about $113,000 per year. These numbers, however, can vary according to the experience, skill set, and location of the Angular developers. In India, the salaries range from approximately 553,000 per year for a web developer to about 633,000 for a full-stack developer. Okay, so now let's move on towards the skills that are required by Angular developers in the industry. Angular in itself is one of the hottest skills that is required. But in order to fetch you the right job and get you a handsome salary, it is required that you have the knowledge of other skills as well. Some of them include JavaScript, TypeScript, HTML and CSS, etc. JavaScript is one of the most essential skills that is expected by many organizations since JavaScript is the backbone of front-end development. TypeScript. Angular is built on TypeScript and hence it makes it very much necessary for Angular developers to have good knowledge of it. HTML and CSS. As a front-end developer, it will give you a great advantage if you know HTML and CSS. Knowledge of IDEs such as Visual Studio, WebStorm, Sublime Text, etc. will prove to be of good advantage. Angular developers are expected to have the knowledge of testing frameworks like Jasmine, Karma, Protractor, etc. Jasmine is a testing framework for JavaScript users. This tool is DOM-less framework and is compatible with Node.js projects. With Jasmine, you can create websites, simple web applications, and Node.js applications. AngularJS Karma. Karma is also a very powerful testing framework for JavaScript applications. This tool provides a testing environment for the developers. Protractor. Protractor is one of the best testing tools for Angular. It can be used as an end-to-end testing framework for Angular applications. Protractor runs in a real browser and is known for its Angular-specific locator strategies. Angular Fire. Angular Fire is a set of libraries that can be utilized to build web and mobile applications easily. Its powerful framework provides the required functionality for JavaScript users. Angular DeckGrid. Angular DeckGrid is a lightweight masonry-like grid for Angular. The directive of this tool does not depend on the visual representation. Mocha. Mocha is a JavaScript library with rich features. This tool uses testing framework based on Node.js and uses the browser to run the test in real time. It also makes asynchronous testing easy and fun. This tool can be used to create multiple Mocha tests and run them simultaneously. RestAngular. RestAngular is the perfect fit for any web application that consumes data from the RESTful API. It can simplify the common get, post, delete, and update requests with the minimum of client-side code. DJ Angular. DJ Angular is a reusable app that provides efficient app integration with Angular. This tool allows you to create Angular content for each application instead of creating a single massive Angular application inside of Django. Okay, so to conclude, I'd like to say that Angular has proved itself to be a worthy investment for web developers and remains as a golden asset for professionals who possess this skill. So now is the best time to take advantage of this positive trend and learn Angular. So this brings us to the end of this session. I hope you guys have enjoyed and learned something new. In case you have any doubts or queries, please do let me know in the comment section and I will revert to you at the earliest. Goodbye and take care.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!